Find it hard to believe the most popular item in the toy store used to be a device made of two blocks of wood and a piece of string. Our Darcy Griffiths checked out a workshop where he found the yo-yo is much more than a toy.
There's that ride. And you get on and you go.
Meet Rob Davies. The 37-year-old Victoria father is an expert at the yo-yo, and he wants to share his love of the toy with today's kids.
It's fabulous for hand-eye coordination. It gives them something to do that they can carry it in their pocket, bring it out at any time, start doing the tricks.
Rob is at Vancouver's Science World this weekend, teaching yo-yo to a generation of kids that never had a toy they didn't have to plug in or turn on. These days, the yo-yo may be a seriously low-tech toy, but never underestimate the appeal of a classic.
Good one.
It builds self-esteem and concentration, it's very good. It keeps their mind on positive things.
If it seems yo-yos have been around forever, it's probably because they have. Rob says they're as old as 450 BC. But for these kids, they're exciting and new.
That's it. Yes, yes, yes. Now, around. Yeah, around. Rolls.
Rob was a teen yo-yo champ, and he finds there are still kids today who are willing to do what it takes to become as good as he is.
Eiffel Tower. The man on the flying trapeze. Backward somersault. Flying saucer.
Some of today's fancy yo-yos can be as much as $250, but you can still get your child a good one for under about 10 bucks. Of course, they have to be willing to put away their Game Boys.
My mom bought me this one.
Is it your favorite toy?
No, my Game Boys.
Jeez. This can't win.